Today we will discuss about vapor absorption refrigeration system. Here I draw a line diagram for vapor absorption refrigeration cycle or VARS. Here I draw evaporator, absorber, pump, generator, analyzer, rectifier, condenser and the expander. The compressor which is be used in the vapor compression refrigeration cycle is replaced by absorber, pump, generator in the VARS. Waste heat we can effectively used in this cycle. The COP of this cycle is very strong, 0.3 to 0.5. COP of this cycle is very strong, 0.3 to 0.5. Solar absorption refrigeration system is a working unit or working system based on this principle. This cycle we prefer in the remote location where the cost of electricity is high. In this cycle we replace pump by the absorber, pump and the generator. So this cycle is less noisy as compared to vapor compression refrigeration cycle. This cycle runs on low grade energy because in this cycle we absorb heat from the sunlight. So this cycle is also known as heat operated unit. We can say this cycle as a heat operated unit. In this cycle we used the pair of the refrigerant and the absorber is that is NH3 ammonia and H2O, where ammonia is a work as a refrigerant and H2O is work as a absorber. One more pair which we are generally not prefer, this is most commonly used pair for the refrigerant and the absorber. One more pair is brine and water, where water act as a refrigerant and brine act as a absorber. In this cycle, two more devices, that is analyzer and rectifier. The refrigerant, which is a mixture of refrigerant and the absorber. So, the mixture of the refrigerant, that is NH3 and H2O, we supply to the generator. Here it absorbs heat and we supply it to the analyzer. After that rectifier, the liquid particle which is present in the refrigerant is separated in the analyzer and rectifier, and the complete elimination of the vapor liquid particle takes place in the rectifier. After the rectifier we get dry NH3 vapor. After the rectifier, complete elimination of the water particle takes place and we get only dry NH3 vapor. So this is some information related to the vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. Now we proceed for the COP calculation. Here evaporator, absorber, generator and condenser. Q is the amount of heat which is absorbed by the refrigerant across the evaporator. QA is the amount of heat which is directed by the refrigerant across the absorber. QG is the amount of heat which is absorbed by the refrigerant into the generator or across the generator. And QC is the amount of heat which is rejected by the refrigerant across the condenser. And T0 is our atmospheric temperature. From the first law of thermodynamics we can write QE plus QG is equal to QA plus QC. So we can write QE plus QG is equal to QA plus QC. Heat absorbed by the refrigerant is equal to heat rejected by the refrigerant. It is our equation first. This we write from the first law of thermodynamics. Second equation we can write from the Clausius inequality. In this we can write QE by TE plus QG by TZ is equal to QA by T naught plus QC by T naught. Because we are rejecting heat to the atmosphere in the absorber and the condenser, so I write the respective temperature for absorber and the condenser is atmospheric temperature. This will our equation second. So we can modify the equation second by QE by TE plus QG by TZ is equal to QA by QC by T naught. Where QA plus QC is equal to QE plus QG, so we can write QE plus QG by T naught, or we can write QE by T naught plus QG by T naught. The common term that is QE and QE we can take left side, and the QG and QC we can take right side. First I write this equation QE by TE plus QG by TZ is equal to QE by T naught plus QG by T naught. This is our modified equation number second. So we can take the common term to the left side and the common term for the heat supply to the generator right side. So TE minus QE by T naught is equal to QZ by T naught minus QG by TZ. In this equation we can take common QE from the left side and the QG from the right side. So we can write QE is equal to 1 by TE minus 1 by T naught is equal to QG QG 1 by T naught minus 1 by TG. Here we are getting desired effect into the evaporator, and we used best heat, or this is our heat operated unit. In this we are supply heat to the generator in place of bulk input. So this is our heat operated unit. So in this QG is our working as a bulk input, because this is our heat operated unit. So we supply in this device QG heat in place of bulk. So COP we can write for this device is QE, that is desired effect by QG. This is our desired effect by bulk input. In this device we are supplying heat to the generator, which is equal to the bulk input for this device. So we can write, or we can or modify this QE is equal to T naught minus TE by TE T naught by QG TG minus T naught by TG T naught. Here the common term is T naught T naught. So T naught T naught get cancelled, and the remaining term after this we can write QE by QG is equal to TG minus T naught by TG and TE by T naught minus TE. This will equal to COP for this cycle, or we can also write COP like this TE by TZ, TZ minus T naught, T naught minus TE. This is our required COP for vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. We can directly calculate this formula, because the highest temperature we get in the generator. After that, the second number temperature is we get in the absorber or to the condenser and the absorber. And the lowest temperature we get in the evaporator. So we can directly write this as a QG, T naught or TE. In these two temperatures we can apply heat engine efficiency formula, and for these two device, for two temperature we can apply refrigerator formula. So from here we can directly get this formula. So I can write 1 minus T naught by TG. This is, you can say, naught, and for these two temperature I am applying refrigeration formula of COP. So we can write TE by T naught minus TE. So we can write TZ by T naught minus TE. So the required formula we get is TE by TG and TG minus T naught by T naught minus TE. So we can directly calculate this formula five with the help of these three temperatures. If we talk about actual COP for this cycle, which is desired effect by work input into the pump and the heat supply to the generator. But in this case, the specific volume for liquid refrigerant is very less. This is actual formula for COP. If you want to write, this is actual formula for the COP for this cycle. But we can write the for ideal case, that is desired effect. In case of work input, we can write QG for this cycle. So this is our ideal case, because for liquid refrigerant the value of the specific volume is very less, so the work input will very less. So we can write ideal formula, actual formula, or we can directly calculate this formula by with the help of these three formula. So we get the required COP is for the vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. This is our naught. In this cycle we used absorber, pump, generator in place of compressor, which is we used in the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. This is our heat operated unit, because we used in this cycle best heat. The COP of this cycle is varies from 0.3 to 0.5, and the most commonly used pair of the refrigerant and the absorber is NH3 and CO2, and the one more pair is brine and H2O, but we are not prefer that. So this is about the vapor absorption refrigeration system. Thank you.